everyone, welcome to the English devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let's begin in prayer. Heavenly Father, I come before your holy presence, and I ask forgiveness of my sins, Lord. Wash me white as snow, cleanse me from all unrighteousness and all the sins that I have done against you or those that you love. Father, I ask that you will be with those who are listening to this devotional today. Open up their spiritual eyes and minds, Lord, to learn something new of you. Father, help them to understand what is being read, what is being said, Lord. Help them to be able to apply it to their lives so they can grow closer to you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Today's devotional was written by Eliudel Gonzalez and translated by Carlos Sunza. It's titled, Rest Without Pressure. Our biblical base comes from Matthew chapter 12, verses 1 through 8. So says the word of God. At that time, Jesus went through the grain fields on the Sabbath, and his disciples were hungry and began to pluck heads of grain and to eat. And when the Pharisees saw it, they said to him, "Look, your disciples are doing what is not lawful to do on the Sabbath." But he said to them, "Have you not read what David did when he was hungry, he and those who were with him, how he entered the house of God and ate the showbread, which was not lawful for him to eat, nor for those who were with him? Have you not read in the law that on the Sabbath the priests in the temple profane the Sabbath and are blameless? Yet I say to you, that in this place there is one greater than the temple. But if you had not known what this means, 'I desire mercy and not sacrifice,' you would not have condemned the guiltless. For the Son of Man is Lord, even of the Sabbath." Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scripture. One of the purposes for which Jesus came to the earth was to give true fulfillment to the law of God, as opposed to what the teachers of his time were doing and teaching. The Pharisees lost sight of the original purpose for which God established the Sabbath, and to make sure that no one violated the limits established by the commandment, they imposed other limits that God had not, thus turning the Sabbath into an oppressive time. The period of great influence of the legalistic men over the people is probably the time when Christ developed his ministry. It is really impressive that more than half of the texts in the Gospels where the Sabbath is mentioned tells us of the criticisms and accusations of Jesus because of the uncompromising and exaggerated way in which the Pharisees forced the people to observe the Sabbath. Our Lord came to reestablish the true purpose of the Sabbath, to bring rest to our souls through this commandment given for man's sake. God, seeking our good, separated the seventh day so that we may worship him in the full freedom of the Spirit and not under the oppression of legalism. Amen. Brothers and sisters, the Lord says in the Word of God that the Sabbath was made for man, not man for the Sabbath. Sabbath was never supposed to be an oppressive time, an oppressive day, a day of burden, and a day of work. No, my brothers and sisters, God made Sabbath for us so that we could find rest for our souls. Spiritual rest, emotional rest, physical rest. God made the Sabbath for you and for me out of his great love. My brothers and sisters, if the Sabbath day has become a burden, I encourage you to have a conversation with your Heavenly Father and tell him all about it. Reevaluate why the Sabbath is a burden for you. Are you putting on yourselves more restrictions than need be? Are you putting on yourselves expectations that God never intended to put on you? Find out why the Sabbath has become a burden to you and go to God with it. Ask for clarity, ask for perspective, and ask for God to show you how the Sabbath is not supposed to be that burden and what you need to change. My brothers and sisters, I promise you, He will do that for you because He loves you and He gave you this day for you, not for Him, for you. Amen. May the Lord receive the honor and the glory.
Happy day. He'll wash my sins away.
Amen, what a beautiful song. And now, my brothers and sisters, I invite you to check out our YouTube channel, SCC English Ministry, for our daily Bible reading as we continue with the book of 2 Samuel. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children, now and forever. Amen.